and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Good morning and welcome to our service of Holy Communion on this, the 14th Sunday after Trinity. Also a service in creation time. Welcome to those of you in church and welcome to those watching at home. Today we hold a tension that we are a nation in mourning and that we are the people of God celebrating the resurrection of our Saviour. You may have seen in the notices that we should be holding special services of commemoration later today in preparation for tomorrow's funeral, and I'll remind you of those services during the notices. There's one or two very, very small differences between what we're going to do and what's on your service sheet. As and when we get to those, I shall make you aware of them. So let's just take a few moments of silence before we say the prayer of preparation together. Almighty God,
to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our first hymn this morning is number 15, All My Hope on God Is Found.
Through dread.
as we acknowledge our human frailty, let us call to mind our sins of word, deed, and omission, and confess them before God our Father. Almighty God,
our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The nation is still in mourning. We shall not sing the Gloria today, but I invite you to sit or kneel in silent prayer before the collect. Almighty God, whose only Son has opened for us a new and living way into your presence, give us pure hearts and steadfast wills to worship you in spirit and in truth. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Ruth is going to be... Okay. So I can now invite Dennis to come and read the lesson for us.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to Timothy. My dearly beloved, I urge that supplications, prayers, intercessions, and thanksgiving be made for everyone, for kings and all who are in high positions, so that we may lead a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness and dignity. This is right and is acceptable in the sight of God our Saviour, who desires everyone to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. For there is one God. There is also one mediator between God and humankind, Christ Jesus, himself human, who gave himself a ransom for all. This was attested at the right time. For this I was appointed a herald and an apostle. I am telling the truth, I am not lying, a teacher of the Gentiles in faith and truth. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We now stand to sing our gradual hymn number 52, Be Still and Know That I Am.
Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. But I said to you that you have seen me and yet do not believe. Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and anyone who comes to me I will never drive away. For I have come down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, but raise it up on the last day. This is indeed the will of my Father, that all who see the Son and believe in him may have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You please be seated. In the name of the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Tomorrow morning at Westminster Abbey, the late departed Elizabeth Alexandra Mary Windsor will be commended into the hands of God. And in the afternoon, her mortal remains will be committed to the Royal Vault at St. George's Chapel, Windsor. And at the close of day tomorrow, the period of national mourning will come to an end and everyday life will return to normal. Except that it won't. It's going to take quite a bit longer than that for things to feel normal. Because one of the fundamental anchoring points of life in this country for the past 70 years will no longer be there. There are still perhaps a few among us who can remember King George. I can't. There are more among us who can remember the Queen's coronation. That was when my grandparents, like so many other households, bought their first television set. And the whole family gathered round to watch the grainy picture on the 16-inch screen. For the overwhelming majority of us, Queen Elizabeth is the only monarch we have ever known. From that young woman with the clear voice and the precisely enunciated vowels, through seven decades, to the much-loved Nations Nan, as Mick called her when he wrote in our condolences book. Impeccably composed, even when politely discussing marmalade sandwiches with Paddington Bear. It's still only a week and a half since we saw her, increasingly frail, yet still very much in command of the situation, meet with Liz Truss and appoint her as Prime Minister. And now she's gone. Over the past few days, Ruth and I have repeatedly turned to the television feed from the lying in state with the very moving juxtaposition of the stunningly precise ritual of the changing of the guard every 20 minutes in full dress uniform and the stern discipline of the two vigils of the princes alongside those lives of thousands and thousands of mourners wearing everything from formal dark suits or uniform to tracksuits and trainers. They've queued for many hours, many of them through the night in very cold temperatures, before moving in a steady stream past the coffin to pay their respects to the Queen. Those lines of mourners include people of many faiths and of none. When they reach the catafalque where the coffin lies, most of them simply pause for a few seconds and bow. Many women curtsy. Some hold their hands in prayer, Christian or Muslim or Hindu or Buddhist. Some place their hand on their heart, and some of them blow her a kiss. But many make the sign of the cross. In a society, in a commonwealth of many historical faiths, but increasingly also of none, Queen Elizabeth was unshaken in her Christian conviction. There are sadly so many today for whom Jesus' promise in today's gospel, that all who believe in the Son may have eternal life, so many for whom that's no longer meaningful. But for Elizabeth, it was a fundamental part of her understanding of the world. And so her funeral at Westminster Abbey tomorrow, with all those dignitaries, won't be merely a state ceremony with religious trimmings. It will be exactly what it says it is, the entrusting of a devout Christian into the hands of our loving Father. Rest eternal grant unto her, O Lord, and may light perpetual shine upon her. May she rest in peace.
And rise, O Lord.
But now, part of the process of transition for us as life moves on is to begin to get used to King Charles. In lots of important jobs, when one person departs, there's an interruption, sometimes quite a long one, before their successor is appointed and takes over. For example, Bishop Michael of Hartford left us already several months ago to become the diocesan bishop of Bath and Wells. There are surely discussions going on about choosing his successor, but none of that is public yet. With monarchs, it's different. We surely all know the catchphrase, "The king is dead, long live the king." And that describes the instant transition of authority when a monarch dies. So for 10 days now, we have been living into the beginning of the reign of King Charles III and watching how he and the other members of the royal family adjust to their new roles. Now, it's no secret that many, many people have been very doubtful about how Charles would make that transition. After waiting in the wings for such a long time, and being very explicit and public and sometimes controversial with his opinions about topics from architecture to the environment. So far, I have to say, I have been impressed by how ready he is for the strange and demanding role of constitutional monarch in a parliamentary democracy. Impressed and reassured by his dignity and discretion and his outreach to people. Our gospel reading today relates specifically to the Queen's funeral tomorrow. It's a gospel about resurrection. But our epistle reading, quite accidentally, is what we would have had anyway this week. And yet, how very, very appropriate it is. The author of the second letter to Timothy urges that supplications, prayers, intercessions, and thanksgivings should be made for everyone, for kings, and for all who are in high position. So as we say our loving farewell to Queen Elizabeth, we also turn to greet King Charles and to pray for him and for his Prime Minister, his first Prime Minister, Liz Truss, appointed by the Queen in her last public act of state, to pray for them that they will have the strength and intelligence and wisdom and discretion to govern this nation well through the massive challenges that face us this autumn and winter and in the years to come. And so let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, we pray you to set your cross and passion between your judgment and our souls, now and at the hour of our death. Uphold and comfort the living, especially those who mourn. Grant to those in authority insight, integrity, and sensitivity. Strengthen your holy church in faith, compassion, and concord, and grant to the departed peace. May the life-giving cross be the source of our joy and peace. Amen.
As you're able, would you please stand and we will affirm our faith in the words of the Creed. So we say together,
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory, to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Please do be seated. Some brief notices. As we mentioned at the beginning of the service, this afternoon and early this evening, there are services of commemoration of Queen Elizabeth II. The first is here at 4 p.m. and then the same prayers and liturgy will also be incorporated into the evening telephone service. The normal details will get you, normal login will get you onto that call. 7 p.m. So 4 p.m. here in church and then 7 p.m. On the telephone service. There will be morning prayer all this week, including Bank Holiday Monday. So if you want to come to morning prayer tomorrow, the church will be open. At the back of church, the parish book of condolence is still there. If you would like to write anything in that, please feel free to do so. Just a note for the future, and that's the various things happening around harvest, the harvest displays and the harvest festival at the beginning of October. And next week, just for those of you watching from home, it is possible that next week we will not be able to stream, but we're not certain yet. So do log on as usual, but it may be that you won't be able to see anything next week. So apologies in advance if that is the case. Those are the only notices that I have. So now if I could invite Jasmine to come forward and lead us in our prayers.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, you promised through your Son, Jesus Christ, to hear us when we pray in faith. We pray for your church as we enter a new era. We give thanks and praise for the life of our wonderful late Queen Elizabeth. We pray for our new monarch, Charles III. Grant him vision and wisdom. Please strengthen our bishop and those who also serve. May all who follow your way be united in your truth and love, and tell of your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the world and for our own lands. May the world learn from the example of our late Queen to follow the way of duty, compassion, and concern for others. Please cherish, guide, and protect Charles, our King, and his family. Give wisdom to our leaders, and to leaders of every country. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless our local community and let there be harmony, safety, and consideration for all. Give grace to us, to our families, friends, and neighbours. May we love as Jesus loves us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have asked for our prayers. Larry, Claire Day, Malcolm Day, Cheryl Day, Sam, Rebecca and Evelyn, John Carroll, Daniel Freilich, Agnes, Nancy, Terence, Pauline and Teresa, Val Biese, Gordon McRae, Jenny Ledster, Dara Warwick, Angela Wardle, Carol and Mick, Catherine Smith, Beth, Brendan, Tony Smith, Dave, Sue Sandry, Walter, and John. May we take a moment to name silently or aloud anyone else we would like to pray for. Comfort and encourage the sick, and bring them hope in their troubles. Let their faith stay strong and their recovery come soon. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
May we offer a prayer of commendation for our late Queen Elizabeth. God, our Creator and Redeemer, by your power, Christ conquered death and returned to you in glory. Confident of his victory and claiming his promises, we entrust your servant Elizabeth into your keeping. In the name of Jesus, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
We give into your care Queen Elizabeth and the local people who have died: Lisa Hearn, Mary James, and we pray for those whose year's mind falls at this time: Marjorie Heskins, Frank Taylor. please, Lord, comfort and strengthen those who mourn. Hear us as we remember Elizabeth and others who have died in the faith of Jesus Christ. Grant to them and us a place in heaven. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Come to the peace, and this is one of those places where there is a small difference between what you have on your sheet and what we're going to do, and that is we're going to, instead of using the sung words that we have in your sheet, we're going to use the ones we used last week, which are, I've got peace like a river, and then the second verse, I've got love like the ocean, and the choir will lead us in that. So please, may I, as you're able, would you please stand for peace. Peace with yourself, peace with creation, peace with one another. The peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
And let us wave as a sign of peace to each other as we sing. Sing our next hymn, number 437, Rock of Ages.
Oh,
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
God of the living and of the dead, you shaped your people through the offices of prophet, priest and king. Through Samuel you anointed a succession of kings. In Jesus you came among us as prophet to restore us to you, priest to bring us into your presence, and King of Kings to reign with you and the Holy Spirit forever. In Queen Elizabeth II, you gave us an example of your goodness and grace, and a witness to your gentleness and glory. In her death, you have given us a moment to rediscover who we are as your people and who you call us to be in your service. With angels and archangels and the company of heaven, we rejoice now that she sings with your communion of saints in your everlasting praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Supper was ended. He took the cup of wine. Again he praised you, gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence, his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people. Gather us in your loving arms and bring us with all the saints to feast at your table in heaven, through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Sit or kneel as we pray with confidence, as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Jesus is the living bread which came down from heaven. If anyone eats of this bread, they will live forever.
Lord, our hearts hunger for you. Give us this bread for always.
Oh,
our communion. So we remember before God, and we pray for Derek, who will be taking communion to Valerie Lyons and Sybil Graham, Glynis, who will be visiting Louis Richards, Jenny, who will be going to Evelyn Moslin and Margaret Brendish, and Pat, who will be visiting Joan Amos. If you're visiting us this morning and you would normally receive communion in your own church, please do come forward and receive communion with us. If you'd like to come forward and receive a blessing, then please come forward holding your service book, so I know it's a blessing you'd like to receive. Draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Thank you.
And rest.
Let us pray. Lord God, the source of truth and love, keep us faithful to the apostles' teaching and fellowship, united in prayer and the breaking of bread, and one in joy and simplicity of heart. In Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And we pray together. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory.
Amen.
And our final hymn is number 518. Thy hand, O Lord, has guided, and we will omit verse 2. Tea or coffee in the parish room after the service, and a reminder of those services this evening of commendation at 4 p.m. here and 7 p.m. on the table. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the church, the king, the commonwealth, and all humankind, peace and concord, and to us and all his servants, life everlasting, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and all those that you love, this and every day.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen. Amen.